So, hello students, good evening to all of you. I hope you all are joining very fast. So we are going to start with the discussion of the critical reasoning section of mock number 36. We are here for the same. I'll wait for a few minutes for you people to join. Anjali Pathak, good evening. Good evening, Anjali. Anjani. Some more people can join, so we'll just wait for a minute or two. I request all of you to join fast. I have shared the link on Telegram channel of ours. So just in case if you have received that particular link, join it fast. We will be discussing the five passages that have been there for this critical reasoning section. So all those questions will be discussed out here. Okay, I can see some of you are joining. So let me get started. So how many of you have joined till now? Shashank Shivam has joined. Niharika Ansu has joined. Subransu Animesh has joined. Okay, we'll get started very soon. Just wait for a moment. So yeah, we are ready for the discussion. We are ready for the discussion of all the questions of critical reasoning section of the mock number 36. In the meantime, in the previous week, we had uploaded this mock test number 36. That was held online. I hope all of you had taken that mock test number 36 and the online experience was pretty good. I believe there were very few hitches, although there were some technical issues on our part, which we tried to rectify off late. So that issue was taken care of and most of you didn't face any issue. We are planning to launch the 37th mock on this Sunday. That is, today is 16th, I believe. So, 19th, you'll be getting 19th, you'll be getting the 37th mock. That will be also held online. There is quite a possibility that we might change the application. The current application on which the mock test number 36 was held might be updated to a newer application altogether. So just in case we do that, we'll be updating all of you regarding that. So stay in touch with us regarding those updations if they are there. We are trying to give you a hassle-free experience of the exact database, that exact interface that is going to be there by the CLAT consortium. In the meantime, all of you must be aware that CLAT consortium also is going to conduct 5 mock tests, and they have come up with a schedule of when these mock tests are going to be conducted. So my kind suggestion to all of you is, please make sure that you take all those mock tests in time, and take those mock tests very seriously, because your performance in those mock tests will be a great measure of what it's going to be in the real examination. So now getting started, coming to the discussion of the day, we'll get started with the very first passage. If you all remember the passage number 1 of the critical reasoning section of mock number 36 was related to Prime Minister KP Oli of Nepal, and it also discussed about some turbulences in the relationship of Nepal with India, the interference of China with Nepal, and how that has impacted on the relationship of Nepal with India. So that has been also discussed in the passage, and the passage primarily discusses about the emergence of KP Oli as a very strong leader in Nepalese politics. So this passage is regarding that only. So we'll get started with, just wait for a moment. So now coming to the discussion of this particular passage, I hope all of you have studied this passage pretty well. And like I always keep telling you people, that while you are reading any passage of critical reasoning, the most important thing that you should look for is, if there are say 2 or 3 paragraphs in the passage, try to look for the conclusion of each and every paragraph. Also, while looking for the conclusion, you should also focus on what all are the premises leading to that particular conclusion. What all are the assumptions taken for coming at that particular conclusion? So my suggestion to you all is, while you all are solving these critical reasoning questions, you must identify the premise, the assumptions, and the conclusions of each and every paragraph given in a particular passage. I have told you earlier as well that in a paragraph, it is quite possible that in that particular paragraph, there is only one conclusion. It is also possible that because that paragraph has, because that passage has three paragraphs, so every paragraph has an intermediate conclusion of its own. So you need to identify those intermediate conclusions, and every conclusion should be backed by a premise. So you need to identify that premise as well. Which all are the premise you need to identify, and if there is any assumption present or not. It is possible that there may be an assumption in a particular passage, in a particular paragraph. It is also possible that there might not be any assumption. So what is an assumption for that matter? I have always told you that an assumption is nothing but a hidden premise. So hidden, what is an assumption? It is a hidden premise. So in this paragraph, you can see that in this passage, there are three paragraphs, and those paragraphs may have a conclusion of their own. The entire passage may have a conclusion of its own as well. So, agar ye pure passage ka agar aap conclusion ki baat karenge, so this passage only talks about the emergence of K.P. Oli as a very strong leader of Nepal, and how is it has it been possible that K.P. Oli has become a very strong leader in Nepal. Now coming to the questions of related to this particular passage. So coming to question number one. Coming to question number one. Question number one says, which of the following can't be inferred from the passage? देखिए जब भी ऐसे questions हो, which of the following can't be inferred? तो इसका मतलब ये होता है कि जो options दिए हुए हैं, उनमें से most of the options, all the options can be inferred. One of the options cannot be inferred. So, बाकी जो statements होंगे वो सारे true statements होंगे, उनमें से सिर्फ एक false statement होगा. तो उस false statement को आपको identify कर लेना है, वही can't be inferred वाले question का answer होगा. Now coming to this question, ये question number one जो है, वो कहता है which of the following can't be inferred from the passage. तो first option says Mr. Oli was not always the dominant voice in country's politics. This is true because the other dominant voice was Mr. Koirala, which has been mentioned in the passage. So this one is true. So it can't be the option. Correct choice. Now coming to the second option says Nepal has experienced frequent shifts in power over the years. This is also true. So this can also be can also not be the correct choice. C says Mr. Oli is not a proponent of Nepalese nationalism, whereas if you read the paragraph, it clearly says that Mr. K.P. Oli is the proponent of Nepalese nationalism. So he is the proponent of Nepalese nationalism. So this statement is false. Now since this statement is false, therefore this cannot be inferred from the passage, and it has to be the correct answer. So the correct answer to question number one should be option number C. Now coming to question number two. क्वेश्चन नंबर टू पे हम लोग आ जाते हैं। तो क्वेश्चन नंबर टू कहता है what role is played by the claim that it is almost an anomaly for a government to last more than 2 years without turbulence or a shuffling of the decks of power in Nepal in relation to the conclusion of the argument. Now it acts as a premise. This of course is not a conclusion, और ये जब conclusion नहीं है तो ये एक premise है, it supports, it provides support to the conclusion by providing an example. तो इसका correct answer क्या होगा? Option number A. ठीक है, क्योंकि conclusion क्या होगा कि मिस्टर केपी ओली हैज इमर्ज्ड एज अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग लीडर ऑफ नेपालीज पॉलिटिक्स, दिस इज अ दिस मे बी अ कंक्लूजन ऑफ द पैसेज, द पैराग्राफ्स ऑफ द पैसेज। सो दिस पॉइंट व्हिच इज बीइंग सेड दैट देयर इज अ कंटीन्यूअस पावर शिफ्ट, देयर इज अ शफलिंग ऑफ पावर इन नेपालीज पॉलिटिक्स, एक्ट्स एज एन आर्ग्यूमेंट, acts as a support to conclusion provided by the acts as a support to the conclusion, and it gives of course as an example of this particular passage, because aap dekhenge passage mein bar bar aap padhenge isme kaha jata hai ki koi bhi government jo hai wo Nepal mein stable nahi rehti hai. There is a continuous power shift in Nepal, and Mr. K.P. Oli is the one who is providing stability to the Nepalese politics. Now, coming to question number three. Question number three पे आ जाते हैं। तो question number three पे कहता है, which of the following explains the reason for recent strain? Recent strain in relationship with India, with whom Nepal shares intricate and dependent ties. मतलब the immediate reason क्या है? What is the which of the following explains the reason for recent strain? तो ये recent strain की बात कर रहा है। आप passage पढ़ेंगे तो passage में clearly mention किया हुआ है कि ये रिसेंट स्ट्रेन वॉज ड्यू टू द डिस्प्यूट ओवर 335 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर ऑफ टेरिटरी विच इज नाउ बीइंग क्लेम्ड बाय नेपाल. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द रीजंस फॉर द रिसेंट डिस्प्यूट विद इंडिया. नाउ कमिंग टू द ऑप्शंस पे अगर हम लोग देखें तो ऑप्शन पे अगर हम लोग देखते हैं तो ये कहता है द रिसर्जेंस ऑफ नेपालीज नेशनलिज्म, नहीं, दिस इज नॉट द रीजन फॉर फ्रिक्स द रिसेंट स्ट्रेन इन रिलेशनशिप विद इंडिया. नेपालीज नेशनलिज्म जो है वो रिसेंट स्ट्रेन का रीजन नहीं है. द आइडिया ऑफ the resurgence of Nepalese nationalism and B, the idea of national Nepalese nationalism. अब देखिए A और B में क्या difference है. A talks about resurgence of Nepalese nationalism. Resurgence मतलब पहले से था Nepalese nationalism और फिर से दब गया था, वो कुछ कम हो गया था, now फिर से re-emerge कर रहा है, that is resurgence. So that was not, of course, the reason. B says the idea of Nepalese nationalism. So Nepalese nationalism is also not the recent the cause of recent deterioration in the relationship with India. Now C says Nepal added 335 square kilometers of its territory in the map from Indian side. इंडियन साइड के टेरिटरी को नेपाल ने अपने मैप में ऐड कर लिया है. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द रीजंस फॉर द रिसेंट स्ट्रेन विद इंडिया. सो द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन शुड बी ऑप्शन नंबर सी. अगर आप देखेंगे अपना आंसर की जो रिलीज किया गया था तो उसमें करेक्ट आंसर जो है वो बी दिया गया था, तो बी जो है वो गलत आंसर है। रीसेंट डिटोरिएशन, रीसेंट स्ट्रेन इन टाइज का रीजन जो है वो एडिशन ऑफ 300 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर ऑफ टेरिटरी इन द नेपलीज मैप बाय नेपाल गवर्नमेंट, वो है रीसेंट रीजन। ठीक है, तो आप इसका आंसर करेक्ट कर ले, 3 का होना चाहिए सी। नाउ मूविंग फर्दर, व्हाट एक्सप्लेन्स द स्लो इरोजन ऑफ टाइज बिटवीन नेपाल एंड इंडिया ओवर टाइम। स्लो इरोजन ऑफ टाइज का रीजन क्या है? स्लो इरोजन ऑफ टाइज का रीजन है द इमर्जेंस ऑफ नेपलीज नेशनलिज्म, और नेपलीज नेशनलिज्म के चलते जो है देर हैज बीन डिटोरिएशन इन द टाइज विद इंडिया। यहां पे आप देख सकते हैं, द डिसीजन हैज एक्सेसरबेटेड द रिसेंट स्ट्रेन इन रिलेशनशिप विद इंडिया विद, यहाँ पे देखिए ऊपर के लाइन में कहता है, इट इज दिस रोल ऑफ बीइंग द मोस्ट कमिटेड वॉइस अगेंस्ट ग्रेटर डिवोल्यूशन ऑफ पावर बेस्ड ऑन आइडेंटिटी एंड दैट ऑफ अ फिगर रिप्रेजेंटिंग नेशनल नेपलीज नेशनलिज्म दैट हैज कैटापल्टेड मिस्टर ओली इनटू हिज करंट रोल एज प्राइम मिनिस्टर हु ऑर्केस्ट्रेटेड द चेंज ऑफ नेपाल्स ऑफिशियल मैप बाय। This decision has exacerbated the recent strain in relationship with India, with whom Nepal shares intricate and dependent ties, but which have slowly eroded over time. So now this says that these ties have slowly eroded over time. So recent erosion ka karan kya hai? 35 square kilometer of territories ka addition. और स्लो इरोजन का कारण क्या है? द इमर्जेंस ऑफ नेपालीज नेशनलिज्म। ठीक है, सो कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, सो द आंसर टू दिस पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन, व्हाट शुड बी द करेक्ट आंसर? द करेक्ट आंसर शुड बी द आइडिया ऑफ नेपालीज नेशनलिज्म, which should be the correct answer. So the correct answer to option number 4, question number 4 should be B. यहाँ पे इसका correct answer C दिया हुआ था, लेकिन इसका correct answer क्या होना चाहिए? B होना चाहिए. So there has been an error in the answer keys. Question number जो इस passage का जो third question है, उसका answer होना चाहिए C. आंसर की में बी दिया हुआ था, और फोर्थ क्वेश्चन जो है उसका आंसर होना चाहिए बी, उसमें सी दिया हुआ था। ठीक है, नाउ मूविंग फर्दर, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इफ ट्रू, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इफ ट्रू would give support to the conclusion that Mr. Oli has become a dominant force, dominant voice in post-monarchy era of Nepal. ठीक है, तो which of the following gives a credence to it, which would support this conclusion that Mr. Oli has become a dominant voice in post-monarchy era Nepal. He has been a supporter of following FDI in retail sector of Nepal. ये गलत, ये गलत। He has successfully completed his tenure as prime minister. नहीं, तो dominant voice नहीं, he could have been a dominant politician. He has successfully completed his tenure as prime minister. So if he successfully completes, he becomes a dominant personality, not a dominant voice. ठीक है, सो दी बी शुड नॉट बी द करेक्ट आंसर. नाउ सी सेज ही हैज एक्सप्रेस्ड हिज सपोर्ट ऑफ नेपालीज डोमेस्टिक इंटरप्राइजेस. नाउ द पैराग्राफ सेज दैट मिस्टर केपी ओली इज अ ग्रेट सपोर्टर ऑफ नेशनली एंड नेपालीज नेशनलिज्म एंड दिस वन टॉक्स अबाउट नेपाल्स डोमेस्टिक इंटरप्राइजेस एंड ही एक्सप्रेस्ड हिज सपोर्ट फॉर नेपाल्स डोमेस्टिक इंटरप्राइजेस. दिस शुडंट बी फ्रॉम, इट शुड बी फॉर. ठीक है, सो ही एक्सप्रेस्ड हिज सपोर्ट फॉर नेपाल्स डोमेस्टिक इंटरप्राइजेस. मतलब देयर्स अ हिंट ऑफ नेशनलिज्म इन दिस वॉइस एज वेल एंड इट इज क्लियरली मेंशन्ड इन द पैराग्राफ दैट मिस्टर केपी ओली इज अ प्रोपोनेंट ऑफ नेपालीज नेशनलिज्म. सो सी शुड बी द करेक्ट आंसर. सी इसका करेक्ट आंसर होना चाहिए. ठीक है, सो दिस वॉज रिगार्डिंग द वेरी फर्स्ट पैसेज ऑफ द पैराग्राफ. पैराग्राफ का फर्स्ट सॉरी ऑफ द क्रिटिकल रीजनिंग सेक्शन फर्स्ट पैसेज को हमने डिस्कस किया. नाउ कमिंग टू द सेकेंड पैसेज. सेकेंड पैसेज पे हम लोग आ जाते हैं. नाउ सेकेंड पैसेज टॉक्स अबाउट द पॉपुलेशन बॉम्ब. ये पॉपुलेशन बॉम्ब की बात कर रहा है एंड हाउ इट हैज इम्पैक्टेड इकोलॉजी, है ना, खासकर माउंटेन्स में कैसे इसने इम्पैक्ट किया है उसके बारे में. माउंटेन इकोलॉजी को कैसे इसने इम्पैक्ट किया है उसके बारे में इसमें डिस्कस किया गया है. सो इट हैज इम्पैक्टेड द, इफ यू रीड इट केयरफुली it says that the whopping 750 crore human population has made an impact on most flora and fauna. theek hai, to ye primarily paragraph jo hai wo it talks about the impact of increase in human population on the ecological balance. theek hai, and how it has impacted. this paragraph also talks about the stray dogs and how these stray dogs are impacting the ecology. it also talks about that point as well. theek hai, so this paragraph, this passage needs a very careful reading. theek hai, now coming to the questions of this particular related to this particular paragraph. questions related to this particular paragraph, क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड जो है वो पहला क्वेश्चन कहता है कि विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कैन बी इन्फर्ड फ्रॉम द पैसेज. मतलब कैन बी इन्फर्ड का मतलब हो गया कि पैसेज में जो बाकी के स्टेटमेंट्स हैं वो इन्फरेंस ड्रॉ नहीं किए जा सकते हैं, उनमें से सिर्फ एक जो है वो इन्फरेंस ड्रॉ किया जा सकता है. So coming to that thing, we'll have a look at the option. The option says the prediction done in the book, the population bomb, was highly stretched. It was no way stretched. It has been clearly justified in the passage. है ना, passage में इसको clearly justify किया गया है. Moving further. बी ऑप्शन कहता है डॉग्स आर बिगर थ्रेट टू एनवायरमेंट देन ह्यूमंस. नो, दिस हैज नॉट बीन सेड. देर हैज नेवर बीन अ कंपैरिजन ऑफ डॉग्स विद ह्यूमंस. सो दिस ऑल्सो कैनॉट बी इन्फर्ड फ्रॉम द पैसेज. दिस इज ऑल्सो इनकरेक्ट. नाउ कमिंग टू सी, सी सेज stray dogs carry tapeworm. Yeah, they stray dogs carry tapeworm. ये कहा गया है, बट इट टॉक्स अबाउट इन्फेरेंस. दिस इज अ जनरल स्टेटमेंट विच हैज बीन गिवन इट इन द पैसेज. इट हैज बीन क्लियरली स्टेटेड. दिस कैन नॉट बी एन इन्फेरेंस ऑफ द पैसेज. इट हैज बीन क्लियरली स्टेटेड. एन इन्फेरेंस इज अ सबटल कंक्लूजन. A conclusion that has not been clearly mentioned, but one thing that can be concluded through logic. So coming to D, D says humans have changed the ecology in Himalayan ranges. Yes, this happens to be the inference of the passage, the paragraph. ये पूरा पैसेज का इन्फेरेंस नहीं हो सकता है, लेकिन एक पर्टिकुलर पैराग्राफ का इन्फरेंस तो ये जरूर हो सकता है. ये एक ऐसा पैसेज है जिसमें डिफरेंट पैराग्राफ्स का डिफरेंट डिफरेंट कंक्लूजन्स है. तो आप याद कीजिए, हमने बात किया हुआ था दैट इन अ पैसेज देर कुड बी मोर देन वन कंक्लूजन्स. सो एवरी पैराग्राफ मे हैव अ कंक्लूजन ऑफ इट्स ओन. सो इट इज वन सच पैराग्राफ वेयर एवरी पैराग्राफ हैज अ कंक्लूजन ऑफ इट्स ओन. So now coming further, इसका तो करेक्ट आंसर हो गया डी. नाउ मूविंग फर्दर, ऑप्शन नंबर टू पे हम लोग आते हैं. क्वेश्चन नंबर टू पे आते हैं, इस पैसेज के सेकंड पैसेज के क्वेश्चन नंबर टू पे आ जाते हैं. तो सेकंड पैसेज का क्वेश्चन नंबर टू कहता है, व्हाट इज द रोल प्लेड बाय द क्लेम That dogs prey on saiga, blue sheep, अर्गली, ठीक है, ये सब दिया हुआ है, and black buck in the argument. So it acts as a premise of the argument. ये conclude क्या करना चाहता है? ये conclude ये करना चाहता है कि stray dogs are trying to disturb the ecological balance. और उसका एक example इसने clearly दे दिया है by saying that these Dogs are preying on mountainous creatures like saiga, blue sheep, pargali and various others. ठीक है, तो उसका एक एग्जाम्पल उसने दे दिया है. Therefore, the correct answer to this should be that ये आर्ग्यूमेंट का प्रेमाइस है, ये एक पर्टिकुलर कंक्लूजन का प्रेमाइस है. Now coming to the third question. Third question कहता है, which of the following, if true, strengthens the inference? Which of the following, if true, strengthens the inference drawn by the author. तो inference यानी एक subtle conclusion, conclusion को ये support करने वाला है, मतलब एक supportive premise दे रहा है. ठीक है, तो हमारा हमारा statement जो क्या होगा, एक supportive premise होगा. ठीक है, तो हम लोग को वो देख लेना है. So, which of the following, if true, strengthens the inference drawn by the author? तो यहां पे कहता है, humans amicably coexist with the flora and fauna in and around their residence. गलत है ना, इसके ठीक अपोजिट कहा गया है पैराग्राफ में. ठीक है, the free ranging dogs आर ओनली फाउंड इन हिमालयन रीजन, ये कहीं नहीं कहा गया है. इंक्रीज इन ह्यूमन पॉपुलेशन मीन्स इंक्रीज इन नंबर ऑफ स्ट्रे डॉग्स. ठीक है, तो विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इफ ट्रू स्ट्रेंथन्स द इंफरेंस ड्रॉन बाई. सो इफ अच्छा, डी कहता है, The ecological balance gets disturbed every time the number of stray dogs increases. Now there's a confusion between C and D. C or D may thoda sa confusing lag sakta hai aapko. Ye pooch raha hai which of the following if true. If true kya baat kar raha hai? Matlab koi not necessarily in the passage these two statements are given to be true. So which of the following if true strengthens the inference drawn by author. To agar ye यहाँ पे देखिए इस पैसेज में एक तरफ ह्यूमंस की बात की गई है और दूसरे तरफ डॉग्स की बात की गई है, लेकिन ह्यूमंस और डॉग्स के बीच में रिलेशन की बात नहीं की गई है कि इन दोनों में क्या कोरिलेशन है. दैट हैज नॉट बीन डिस्कस्ड इन द पैसेज एंटायरली, है ना. सो इट हैज बीन लेफ्ट टू इमेजिनेशन बाय इट हैज बीन लेफ्ट टू इमेजिनेशन ऑफ द रीडर बाय द ऑथर. So if it says that increase in human population means increase in number of stray dogs, then it can be clearly inferred that due to the population bomb, the ecological balance is going to get disturbed. ठीक है. So C should be the correct answer for this. ठीक है. Now coming to क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर ऑफ दिस पैसेज. ये पैसेज कहता है विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग रिप्रेजेंट्स द मेन पॉइंट मेड बाय द ऑथर. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग रिप्रेजेंट्स द मेन पॉइंट मेड बाय द ऑथर. सो द मेन पॉइंट इज द मेन आइडिया ऑफ द पैसेज. ठीक है, मेन आइडिया की बात कर रहा है. तो वी नीड टू बी केयरफुल व्हाइल आंसरिंग दिस क्वेश्चन. Which of the following represents the main idea, main point? So the book, the population bomb, predicted the population explosion correctly. No, it didn't. It does not talk about the prediction of this book, population bomb. There is more to this passage than this book itself. There are many other points that have been discussed in the passage. There is a discussion regarding the effect of the stray dogs in the passage, which has not been captured in the book, the population bomb. ठीक है, B पे आ जाते हैं. Stray dogs cause to up to 10% fatalities among yaks. तो ये भी अनरिलेटेड पॉइंट है, अनरिलेटेड कंक्लूजन है. ठीक है. सी कहता है एक्सप्लोडिंग ह्यूमन पॉपुलेशन लेड टू इकोलॉजिकल डिसरप्शन इन वेरियस रीजन्स. दिस इज द एसेंस ऑफ द पैसेज. तो एसेंस ऑफ द पैसेज क्या हो सकता है, यही बात इसने करने की कोशिश की है. ऑथर ने इस पैसेज में करने की कोशिश की है कि पॉपुलेशन बॉम्ब से पॉपुलेशन बॉम्ब के चलते, पॉपुलेशन एक्सप्लोजन के चलते, है ना, कैसे इकोलॉजिकल बैलेंस जो है इज गेटिंग डिस्टर्ब्ड. दैट हैज बीन डिस्कस्ड इन द पैसेज. नाउ कमिंग टू पॉइंट नंबर क्वेश्चन नंबर फाइव. क्वेश्चन नंबर फाइव पे आ जाते हैं. What is the role played by the author's description of the similarity discovered between Himalayan and Andes by the team in relation to the conclusion? So, of course, it gives it supports the conclusion by providing an example. This is a simple question. ये example दिया है, है ना? So this was not a very complex question. This was a rather simple one. So we have come to the end of the second passage of this critical reasoning section of mock number 36. Now coming to the third passage. अब third passage पे हम लोग आ जाते हैं. थर्ड पैसेज पे आ जाते हैं, पैसेज नंबर थ्री। अब पैसेज नंबर थ्री जो है, दिस टॉक्स अबाउट दी या द साइटिंग ऑफ वेरियस वाइल्ड एनिमल्स इन द ह्यूमन हैबिटेट इज प्राइमरली बींग डिस्कस्ड आउट हियर, दैट व्हाट हाउ इज द प्रेजेंट लॉकडाउन, हाउ ड्यूरिंग द प्रेजेंट लॉकडाउन ड्यू टू द लैक ऑफ ह्यूमन एक्टिविटी द एनिमल्स फ्रॉम द वाइल्ड आर इमर्जिंग इन टू आर बींग साइटेड इन द ह्यूमन हैबिटेट primarily the areas where they were not where they were not able to be seen for a very long time. So this is what is being discussed in this particular passage. ठीक है, तो आपने ये passage अच्छे से पढ़ा होगा। This passage has three paragraphs. In paragraphs का अलग-अलग points discuss किए गए हैं इन paragraphs में। ठीक है, सो नाउ कमिंग डायरेक्टली टू द क्वेश्चन, दिस पैराग्राफ इज ऑल्सो नॉट अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट वन, इट्स रादर वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग, सो इट्स एन इंटरेस्टिंग रीड एंड यू कैन इजिली कोरिलेट विद इट बिकॉज दिस थिंग्स हैव कम इन न्यूज वेरी क्वाइट ऑफन। So what is the main point of the passage? Main point of the passage kya hai? So humans have transgressed the landscape of earth. This could be the main point. So human transgression ki to baat दिस कुड बी वन ऑफ द पॉसिबल ऑप्शंस, क्योंकि ह्यूमन ट्रांसग्रेशन की तो बात कर रहा है। बी, एनिमल्स आर फर्स्ट कमिंग, मेन पॉइंट ऑफ द पैसेज की बात कर रहा है। एनिमल्स आर फर्स्ट टाइम कमिंग आउट ऑफ द अर्बन एरियाज ड्यू टू द लॉकडाउन। यस, ये भी हो रहा है, लेकिन ये मेन पॉइंट नहीं हो सकता है। सिमिलरली ए कैनॉट बी द मेन पॉइंट, it has been clearly mentioned in the first paragraph of the passage. ठीक है, C says that mountain gorilla are most vulnerable to coronavirus. So this cannot be the main point of the passage. It has been discussed in the last passage. तो ये main point नहीं हो सकता है. So according to me, the correct answer should be option number डी। ठीक है, इसका करेक्ट आंसर क्या होना चाहिए? ऑप्शन नंबर डी होना चाहिए। सो व्हाट इज द मेन पॉइंट? द मेन पॉइंट ऑफ द पैराग्राफ, एवरी पैराग्राफ इन दिस पैसेज हैज अ पॉइंट दैट हैज बीन डिस्कस्ड इन दैट पर्टिकुलर पैराग्राफ। सो देर इज नो immediate point which can be the main point of the paragraph. Like I have said, that since there are 3 to 4 paragraphs in this particular passage, there could be 4 points or 4 types of 4 conclusions in this particular passage. So there is no the conclusion of this particular passage. So therefore D should be the correct answer. Now coming to question number 2. Coming to question number 2, question number 2 कहता है, which of the following can't be inferred from the passage? Protecting mountain, मतलब बाकी सब इन्फर किए जा सकते हैं, एक जो है वो इन्फर नहीं किया जा सकता है, that you need to identify. So option number A, protecting mountain gorillas from getting infected from COVID is a huge concern. It's a concern, it's true. So A cannot be the answer. We humans are occupied more than 40. We humans have occupied more than 40% of the land. That is true, because the paragraph clearly says that 45 to 50% of the land has been occupied by humans. So the correct B happens to be a correct inference. That is why it cannot be the answer. Gharials have been sighted in the Ganges for the first time ever. This is not, it has been sighted quite often during the lockdown, but it is not the first time that the gharials have been sighted in the Ganges. So correct answer C cannot be inferred from this particular passage. So C cannot be the inference, and that is why C is the correct answer. ठीक है, correct answer जो है वो C होगा. So 2 का correct answer is C. Now moving further, question number 3 पे हम लोग आते हैं. कहता है, the statement geo geologists have argued that it is we humans who have transgressed and changed the landscape of Mother Earth plays which of the following roles in the argument. So it acts as the conclusion. It is an inference drawn by the author. It acts as a conclusion of the argument. It acts as a premise of the argument. No, the correct answer to this question should be the option number C. Okay? It acts as a, although it has not been clearly mentioned in the passage, C happens to be an inference of the particular passage. C kya hai? Inference hai. The statement geologists have argued that it is we humans who have transgressed and changed the landscape of Mother Earth plays which of the following roles in the argument? It acts as an inference drawn by the author. And it acts as a conclusion of the argument, following role in the argument. So it acts as an inference here. Moving further. Set 3 of question. Prasoon, what is your question? What is, sir, will you do one additional thing? What is that thing, Prasoon? Prasoon, kya hai wo additional thing jo aap karne ke liye bol rahe hain? See, in this, like I have said, in question number 3, there might be a confusion between option number B and C. So, although the correct answer to this question has been mentioned as option number C, option number B could also be the answer, because it directly talks about conclusion. And this thing has been mentioned in the passage. Landscape of Mother Earth. So say, what is the difference between an inference and a conclusion? A conclusion is something which is clearly mentioned in the passage. Clearly mentioned in the passage. And an inference is something which is a conclusion which is not clearly mentioned. It is a type of conclusion which is not clearly mentioned in the passage. So it's a subtle conclusion. It's an indirect conclusion by the author. It has not been explicitly mentioned. So now, since the in question number three, the statements have been explicitly mentioned, so therefore we can say that option B should be the correct answer. So I would suggest that you correct the option for this particular question. It should not be C, it should be B. Now Prasoon says, sir, after logical, try to discuss set 3 of QT. Prasoon, I do not have the questions right now of QT. Set 3 questions I do not have at present, because the questions are there in this system. And as you can see, I have tried to copy the questions in the Word file. So I have copied only the logical reasoning, critical reasoning questions for discussion of the day. So someday I'll copy the questions of QT set 3 and I'll discuss with you. Okay? Now moving further, question number 4, which of the following explains the concern of Marco Lambertini? So Marco Lambertini talks about the similarity between DNA of, he talks about similarity between the chances of corona infection of the mountain gorillas. So Marco Lambertini ki agar aap baat karenge, तो आप देखें पैसेज में यहां पे बात किया हुआ है मार्को लैम्बर्टिनी. इंसिडेंटली दैट अपीयर्स टू बी या मार्को लैम्बर्टिनी एंड ही टॉक्स अबाउट हिज कंसर्न इज अबाउट COVID-19 कुड इन्फेक्ट माउंटेन गोरिल्लाज. तो यहां से आपको डायरेक्ट इस क्वेश्चन का आंसर मिल जाएगा, है ना. सो फोर का क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 का करेक्ट आंसर क्या होगा? क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 का करेक्ट आंसर होगा सी. ठीक है, 4 का करेक्ट आंसर इज कोरोना वायरस इन्फेक्शन इन माउंटेन गोरिल्लाज इज अ प्राइमरी कंसर्न ऑफ मार्को लैम्बर्टिनी. ठीक है, सो ये क्वेश्चन काफी आसान था, है ना. हम लोग नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन की तरफ बढ़ते हैं. नाउ मूविंग टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर पैसेज. ये कहता है, what role is played by the author's description of an elephant that was reported to come down unusually near Harki Pauri in Haridwar in relation to the conclusion? So it supports the conclusion by providing an example. So fifth question number 5 का correct option क्या होना चाहिए? It should be option number A. So with this we have completed the discussion of the third passage of the critical reasoning section. Now we'll move to the fourth passage of this particular section. So aap log fourth passage pe aa jaiye, hai na. Now coming to the fourth passage. Ab ye fourth passage jo hai wo काफी मेडिसिन रिलेटेड पैसेज है. बायोलॉजी इंटेंसिव बायोलॉजी काफी बायोलॉजी से भरा हुआ ये पैसेज है. खासकर वायरोलॉजिस्ट के इंटरेस्ट का ये पैसेज है. So at the very first glance, it might not interest you and you may find some difficulty while reading the passage. But if you carefully read it, you won't find any difficulty in this particular passage as well. It talks about the development of antibodies in the human after any viral infection and how these antibodies subside over a period of time, how they subside in case of SARS, how they SARS-CoV-2, how they subside in case of 2000-2003 SARS and MERS, okay? And somebody who has recuperated from a viral infection, okay? उसका भी फर्दर री इन्फेक्शन का चांसेस हो सकता है. एंड हाउ डू दीज एंटीबॉडीज प्ले अ रोल इन प्रोटेक्टिंग अ ह्यूमन फ्रॉम दैट और फाइटिंग द वायरस हैज बीन प्राइमरली डिस्कस्ड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर पैसेज. ठीक है, तो हम लोग आ जाते हैं डायरेक्टली क्वेश्चंस पे. क्वेश्चन कहता है विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कैन बी इन्फर्ड फ्रॉम द पैसेज. पैसेज कहता है कि अ पर्सन हैविंग एंटीबॉडीज अगेंस्ट मर्स इज टोटली सेफ फ्रॉम री इन्फेक्शन. ठीक है, ये गलत है क्योंकि इसमें बताया गया है कि मर्स जो है वो लगभग साल दो साल में सबसाइड कर जाता है. एंटीबॉडीज जो है वो डिप्लीट हो जाते हैं और वंस द एंटीबॉडीज डिप्लीट देर आर चांसेस ऑफ reinfection. So only humans can develop antibodies against viruses. This is nowhere discussed in the passage. There are only two kinds of immune system in a human body. नहीं, ये भी कहीं mention नहीं किया हुआ है. Our cellular immune system is designed to destroy the bad cells if needed. It has been discussed in the last but one paragraph of the passage. ठीक है, so question number one का correct answer should be option number D. Option number D should be the correct answer. Now moving further, which of the following can't be inferred from the passage. So इसमें वही हो गया कि बाकी सारे options जो हैं वो correct होंगे, एक option incorrect होगा. ठीक है, तो जो incorrect वाला option है उसको हमको correct answer बता देना है. ठीक है, जो incorrect inference है उसको हमको tick करना है. So which of the following can't be inferred from the passage. One virus is not as deadly as a million viruses. So two का correct answer can't be inferred. One virus is not as deadly as a million viruses. This can be inferred because मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ इन्फेक्शन की बात की गई है, इंटेंस वायरल लोड की बात की गई है पैसेज में, कि अगर वायरल लोड ज्यादा हो तो इन्फेक्शन के मतलब इन्फेक्शन गेट्स कन्वर्टेड इनटू डिजीज, है ना, और वायरल लोड कम होता है तो बाद में एंटीबॉडीज आर एबल टू फाइट देम एंड देर आर चांसेस दैट द सिम्टम्स माइट नॉट बी विजिबल इन द ह्यूमन who has got infected. So A cannot be the option. B says a person can get reinfected from COVID-19 virus. Yes, it can be inferred. So B option nahi hoga. C says a person can't get reinfected from MERS virus. नहीं, ये गलत है, है ना? So C is wrong inference. Therefore C should be the correct answer. हमारा correct answer क्या होगा? C होगा, क्योंकि this is a wrong inference. ठीक है? और ये पूछ रहा है कि which of the following can't be inferred. तो MERS के बारे में आपने देखा था कि MERS virus का भी जो है एंटीबॉडीज अगर सबसाइड कर जाएं तो सबसाइड करने के बाद से रीइंफेक्शन के चांसेस जो है वो बढ़ जाते हैं. नाउ मूविंग फर्दर, ये कहता है व्हाट इज द कंक्लूजन ऑफ द थर्ड पैराग्राफ ऑफ द पैसेज. तो थर्ड पैराग्राफ पे आइए। थर्ड पैराग्राफ में ये कहता है सास री इन्फेक्टेड लोड की बात करता है, एंटीबॉडी कैन गेट री इन्फेक्टेड डिजीज स्टेट, ठीक है, एंटीबॉडीज इवन व्हेन प्रेजेंट इन लो लेवल्स विल बी प्रोटेक्टिव अगेंस्ट डिजीज। मतलब ये प्राइमरली कहता है कि अगर किसी पर्सन में एंटीबॉडीज अगर लो लेवल में भी प्रेजेंट है तो दैट विल हेल्प हिम फाइटिंग द डिजीज एट सर्टेन लेवल, फॉर सर्टेन लेवल। तो ये कहता है व्हाट इज द कंक्लूजन ऑफ द थर्ड पैराग्राफ ऑफ द पैसेज, अ पर्सन विद लो एंटीबॉडी लेवल कैन गेट री इन्फेक्टेड बट द वायरल लोड विल बी लो। सो आगे का ऑप्शन हम लोग देखते हैं। बी सेज दैट पीपल प्रीवियसली इन्फेक्टेड विद SARS-CoV-2 कैन बी री इन्फेक्टेड सून आफ्टर। सी कहता है एंटीबॉडीज स्पेसिफिक टू अ वायरस इवन व्हेन प्रेजेंट इन लो लेवल्स विल बी प्रोटेक्टिव अगेंस्ट द डिजीज। सो सी जो है वो क्लियर कट आंसर है, ठीक है, सी जो है वो क्लियर कट आंसर है, ठीक है। नाउ मूविंग टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 4। What is the role played by the claim that the combination of adaptive response and cellular immunity may prevent progression of severe illness or reinfection by the same virus in the argument? So, it acts as a premise of the argument. 4 ka correct answer kya hoga? So, what is the role played by the claim that the combination of adaptive response and cellular immunity may prevent progression of severe illness or reinfection by the same virus in the argument? So, it acts as a conclusion of the argument. ये क्या है? Conclusion की बात कर रहा है, ठीक है? So, it acts as a conclusion of the argument. So, fourth का correct answer क्या होगा? B होगा। Now, moving further, government of UK issuing certificates to people infected with virus who have developed antibodies. Which of the following statements, if true, would justify the policy enacted by the government? So people who have survived the virus are ignorant about the safety measures because as they feel they are immune to the virus now. So isme is question mein primarily what is being asked is that government of UK is distributing certificates to those who have recuperated from the COVID-19 virus, है ना? उनको एक certificate issue किया जा रहा है। तो why do we justify such an action of the such a policy of the government? ये पूछा जा रहा है इस question में। तो पहला कहता है people who have survived the virus are ignorant about the safety measures as they feel they are immune to the virus now. So this couldn't be a part of the policy because it talks about carelessness of the people. So A cannot be the answer. Moving to question number B, it says many countries have successfully contained the viral load to a negligible level. Now this could be a possible answer because through this policy that the government of UK by issuing a certificate to people who were infected by COVID-19, were issued a particular certificate. By this, they are able to segregate between people who have been infected and people who have not been infected. Now, people who have been infected have developed antibodies in them and they will be able to fight the virus and the chances of reinfection are pretty low in them. And so the government can focus on people who did not have a history of COVID infection. So B could be a possible answer. Now C says South Korea is seeing resurgence of infection, especially among those infected earlier. आपके करेक्ट आपके आंसर की में करेक्ट आंसर जो है वो ऑप्शन नंबर सी दिया हुआ है. सी कैन नॉट बी द आंसर. ये एकदम कंफ्लिक्टिंग है. ठीक है, सी जो है वो कतई आंसर नहीं होगा. जो आंसर होने का चांसेस है वो थोड़ा बहुत बी के ही होने का चांसेस है. सो आई वुड सजेस्ट यू टू करेक्ट द आंसर टू दिस पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन टू बी बी. एंड व्हाई बी कुड बी द आंसर, I have explained you the reason that because of this policy by issuing certificate to the patients who have recovered from COVID-19, since those patients have developed antibodies in them, and that is why they were able to successfully fight the virus, and the chances of them to be reinfected in the short run is pretty low. Because they already have antibodies. So the government can focus on those people to whom the certificates have not been issued, or to whom have not been infected. Now coming to passage number 5. Now, if you look at the passage number five talks about the recent Chinese intrusion. And so this passage is related to the Chinese intrusion into the Indian territory of Ladakh. And it also talks about the statement issued by Prime Minister and how he had to give clarification to his statement, wherein he had said that there was no such intrusion. So this was a careless statement given by the Prime Minister, and how a careless statement like this can be hijacked by the hostile country to their own advantage has been discussed in the passage out here. So we directly come to the question. Question number one कहता है, which of the following can be inferred from the passage? मतलब बाकी सब false होंगे, एक true होगा. Chinese troops did not cross the LAC. गलत. Which of the following can be inferred from the passage? ये गलत. They had inferred and they had crossed the crossed the LSE. PM was not aware of the Chinese intrusion. No, he was aware. So B cannot be the answer. The author belongs to the Congress Party. The author belongs to the Congress Party. We can nowhere say he could be from Communist Party. He could be an ordinary individual. He could be a critic. He could be a hardcore nationalist. He could be anyone. So we cannot infer about the author, anything about the author. D, PM had to clarify his speech on the situation of LAC more than once. Yes, this has been clearly mentioned in the passage. So correct answer to question number one should be option number D. Now moving further, question number 2 पे आ जाते हैं हम लोग. Which of the following can't be inferred from the passage? तो can't be inferred की जब बात की जा रही है तो वही एक स्टेटमेंट जो है वो ट्रू होगा, एक स्टेटमेंट फॉल्स होगा और बाकी सारे ट्रू होंगे. तो which of the following can't be inferred from the passage? So the author is a member of the Congress Party. This cannot be inferred. So this cannot be inferred. Just now we had discussed ठीक है. सो ए ए विल बी द आंसर, ए विल बी द आंसर. यहां पे क्लियरली दिख रहा है वी कैनॉट इन्फर दैट द ऑथर इज फ्रॉम द कांग्रेस पार्टी. So A will be the answer. So the correct answer to option number two is option number option. Question number two is option number A. ठीक है. अब चलिए move करते हैं question number three पे. What is the role played by the claim that sharing every detail in the public domain is not possible when it comes to negotiating sensitive issues of national security? In the argument, it is it acts as a premise to the argument. So question number three का correct answer क्या होगा? Option number A, ठीक है? इसका correct answer होगा option number A. Three का correct answer is option number A. Now moving further, which of the following statement is the author most likely to agree with? The government of India should cut off ties with Chinese government. The governments should see. We should not go by the whims and fantasies. We should give a rational answer. Now, if you delve into the paragraph. Paragraph talks about that these situations should be sorted out through diplomatic channels, proper diplomatic channels. So, although this option number A looks appealing, this cannot be the correct answer. So, which of the following statements? So, A won't be the answer. A won't be the answer. B, the government should establish proper diplomatic channel to find the solution of the dispute. B should be the correct answer. So fourth ka correct answer should be B. Now moving to question number five. What is the role played by the claim that PM's remark has already been seized upon by the Chinese state media in relation to the conclusion? So it supports the conclusion by providing an example. So question number five ka correct answer should be option number A. How does it support the conclusion by providing an example? Because it says that the Chinese media seized this opportunity of the statement given by the Indian Prime Minister that there was no intrusion, by their claim that in fact there was no intrusion, which the Chinese officials have constantly been saying that there has no be intrusion be from their part, whereas the fact remains opposite. So it strengthens the claim it supports the conclusion by giving an example. So this was all regarding the discussion part of the critical reasoning section of mock number 36, which was very important. Time and again, we people have constantly suggested you people to read as much as is possible. If you look at the kind of passages that we have picked up for this mock test, you'll realize that these are contemporary topics picked up from various newspapers. So our sincere advice to you all is read as many contemporary issues as is possible, because they'll enhance your knowledge and also help you in being a rational thinker, which is very much required while you are answering questions of critical reasoning. Because ultimately what matters is what is that rational thinking is the must for answering questions of critical reasoning. So this was all from our side. hope you had a clear understanding of all the questions of critical reasoning. If you have any query, you can always get in touch with us. I've already shared my number with you people. So thank you for watching this video. We'll try coming up with the mock tests as soon as possible. We have fixed, as of now, the tentative date for the mock test is the 19th of July, that is Sunday. We have planned that we'll be launching the mock test on that third day. As I have told you earlier, that we have come up with a new application, so we'll be posting the new mock test in that application itself, because the previous application had certain issues. So on that particular note, I'll try to end this session for today. Thank you for watching this video. Bye-bye.